What's up, guys? I'm Tim Geddes. This is Greg Miller. Let's just roll it. Let's just roll it right here.
Horizon Zero Dawn, Tim. This
you,
is it.
You went down to LA. You played this game.
Yeah, I did.
Is it good?
Horizon Zero Dawn is fucking awesome. Totally awesome. Yeah, you're gonna see it here. We're gonna go through it. What spoke to me about it was the fact that it is so many of my favorite kinds of games combined. You see Uncharted there. This is an RPG like The Witcher. I feel like it has Last of Us influences because we're dealing with the, you know, the destruction of our world. There's this sci-fi to it with this. You're about to jump in and see it is also Fallout. These conversations strike me so much like Fallout for good and bad.
Yeah.
Obviously, like, this is
awkward
the part where you're like,
facial animations.
Yeah, exactly. And when I edited this footage together, went to LA, played with a whole bunch of other games media types. A bunch of weird restrictions for it, for what we can show you, what we can't show you. Basically, we can show you 20 minutes of footage. So I've edited 20 minutes of footage together. Of that 20 minutes, nothing can be longer than 5 minutes in terms of a chunk. The reasoning behind this from PlayStation is the fact that so much of this game is traversing the land that they don't want you to think that this is boring because you're watching it and you're not doing it. Because let me tell you right now, this is awesome. I talked to that woman, I'm on a side quest, I'm gonna go find her brother, but on the way, I see a boar off to my right, a turkey off to my left, I decide to take out the turkey because this game is such an RPG. When I finished it, people came up to me and they were like, well, what did you think? You know, and I'm like, they were like, did it exceed your expectations? And I was like, well, my expectations were already so high, I'm glad that it delivers, that I think this game's awesome, but I didn't expect it to be, I knew it was gonna be an action RPG, I didn't expect it to be so much RPG.
Yeah.
You're gonna see in this quest, me making dialogue choices, influencing how that ends, doing these different things. But like, this is the action RPG part of it, right? This is Aloy, of course, you've heard about her. I'm level 7 in the game right now. There was a jump, but we got to play it from the very beginning and then jump ahead. Going through hunting, whether I'm hunting a turkey, whether I'm hunting a watcher like that.
Real quick, so yeah. when it speeds up like that, that's you editing that.
Then it's not part of a 5 minute thing. I'm going fast through it because I don't want you to get bored or to violate any embargoes.
Great, can I stop you real quick?
Yeah.
The sound design in this game is excellent.
Oh my, dude, everything's excellent about that game. That's what I'm saying, is the fact that like I'm trying to cram so much into this let's play. This is me playing, and you'll see because I screw things up or whatever, but like, it's got Batman detective mode in it. You know what I mean? Like, it's not just let's go through and hunt and make a bigger pouch for our arrows and go through and get more medicine and stuff like that. There is this very much, okay, cool, I'm on this side quest, I need to find this guy. And it all comes down to the little triangle on Aloy, the side of her head, right?
Yeah. A little Bluetooth messenger thing?
Exactly. When this game got debuted and we saw that, I think my initial impression was, oh, this is how their tribe works. They look like they're, you know, primitive, but they're in our world, but they have this, and so this is what's going on. It turns out she's the only one with this. And I don't want to spoil that as we go through and play the game or whatever, but if I can actually, I think they do, I don't want to spoil how she gets it or what happens in this in the game, right? But the game does such a great job of mixing in explanation without making it feel like they're beating you over the head. You know how many games you play where it's like, here's clearly the tutorial, here's what's happening. The game opens in a way where you're like, oh, this would make sense of why I'm learning the way I'm learning. And then when she gets the triangle and it's just her who gets it, you see the interface and everything like that. But there's this great scene where you know, somebody hands her a bow after for the first time after she has it, and she grabs it and she's like, bow, and she looks and it says bow. And if you look up there, how it says Mother's Cradle, no one else can see that. That's the device translating their language.
So the HUD is actually, she sees the HUD.
She's seeing the HUD and doing all these different things. Obviously, she's using here to track this guy to find the blood paths and do this.
Uh-huh.
But like, again, mixing in all the different things I fucking love, the influences from BioShock in this, and the influences of both BioShock, Fallout, and definitely The Last of Us in terms of environmental storytelling, the way this device works, like, in the first time you get it, you walk around and you're trying to piece together what happened in this room, and you're doing it by listening to audio diaries these people have left behind, and you're doing it, and it doesn't do that cardinal sin, I feel, of I'm listening to the audio diary and I start moving, it stops. Like, I listen to the audio diary and I get to go explore there. And they're like, some of them are happy audio diaries and I see everything that's happened horribly here. We're jumping, this is into going into talking to a merchant, of course. You can buy weapons, do all these different things. I, of course, wanted to get a new outfit. I end up going with a silent hunter thing, because as you see throughout this, hunting and stealth are a big part of this game in terms of how I play. You can play it however you want to. But when you see me creeping through the bushes, that's it. Here we find the bro. This is the end of this side quest, right? And I'm gonna skip through it, of course, in a little bit, but he's crazy. Voices in his head. What do we want to do with him? You know what I mean? That kind of thing.
So, we'll push.
No! Well, I don't think you can do that, but as you come up here, right?
No.
This is one of the things I think that the game is very, very good at. And I don't know how many of these are going to be peppered in throughout the game, but the couple that I got, I'm pretty stoked about, right? Is the fact that choices in video games, nothing new. Mm-hmm. What they let you do here, though, is I would say craft an emotional narrative in the way that this pops up, right? And it's, when these choices come, you can either take the aggressive fist approach, the heart loving approach, or the brain thinking approach, right? And decide how you want to handle a given situation. This is not like Knights of the Old Republic, where you're going to sway good or bad. It's not Infamous, where you're making a choice and you're going to be penalized or what. You're making these in the moment. They'll affect that moment. There might be mentions of them later on, but it's not like I'm going to be a dick to him, so I'm going to have this quest later on cut
off. It's like real life shit.
Exactly, you know? exactly. And so you get, like, the one that I liked a lot that I don't know how it'll play out is the first choice of this pops up. It was like, I got hit with a rock. And so it's like, do I want to attack the person, let him go, or do I want to, like, disarm him?
Yeah.
And it was like that kind of thing. And I really am excited to craft my own Aloy that way and decide how that goes and go through it and not have it, you know, wait on the entire experience. Mm-hmm. So then, yeah, we go through. This is a choice at the end. It was either he's dangerous to others or you should go with him because his sister shows up or whatever. I said he's dangerous, right? Tell him to bugger off. I don't need him. Then, like, okay, cool. Now, this is another one of those moments of, like, what I'm talking about. I don't want to... I'm not trying to say it's not all sunshine and rainbows, but, like, this whole interaction between them here with her in particular is super awkward. Like, look at her eyes. Yeah, like watch.
I thank you for that, Aloy. But now, I must be alone.
Like the way her eyes went, you're like, oh my god, I'm gonna murder this woman. It's like, oh no, the game's just wigging out.
Yeah.
Whatever. It's a giant open world RPG.
Oh, here
Here's me
go.
Riding a mount. You'll see me later on. I get to come in and I'll show you how to take, go in and reprogram one of these to get it to be your thing. Once you have it though, again, very Witcher-like. You see over there the D-pad, right?
Yeah.
Behind us. You see the D-pad there. The option I have on down D-pad is call your mount. Once you have the mount until it gets killed or like separated from you, you can call it. It'll run up to you like Rhodes. You get to do it. Interesting about this that it took me a second to figure out is the fact that up is always health, as you see the little cross. Down, though, is whatever is on that lower bar. So when you hit right, left, you cycle between it. So you can see I have a health potion, I have the horse, and then I have exclamation, which calls people or calls the... distracts people and brings them over to me. Here we're riding into one of the derelict worlds. We were going through, I saw this off of my map, as you can see, there's this fog of war, but up there to the north, that blown out city is where we're going, right?
Cool.
This is it as you go into it, and what's cool about this is when we go into it, of course I love the whole apocalypse. What happened here? What happened to our world? What's going on? She's talking about a signal. It turns out to be the giant walker coming through right here, the tall neck. Now, the tall neck then pops up. It's one of this open activities. It's one of my things over here. Tall necks, it turns out, in this game, act like in an Assassin's Creed, going up and synchronizing.
Got it.
So you saw the map there in that fog of war. Now I need to climb up this guy, right? And then go up there, reprogram it, and it'll fade away. But you can't crawl from the ground. You have to go up and flank. So I put this in here. Again, this is me playing this for the first time, jumping ahead too. So I don't know what the hell I'm doing. So I'm like, cool, I'm gonna jump on this thing.
Oh my god, the colors of this.
Oh crap, there's a monster right there. So I immediately have to do it. I run up. Luckily, you'll see it coming up. You see the yellow exclamation above their head. It's like, that means they know something's wrong and has to fill in to red for them to know it's you and come at you. So I'm like, cool, I'm gonna use this weapon over here that you'll see in a little bit more gameplay later on that you can put down basically a tripwire that electrocutes. Ooh. I screw it up, but I'm still able to drop it in the right thing, which zaps him, which lets me run over, and I had already upgraded to get a critical hit, so I'm able to jab that right into his face and do it. But this is all organic. It's the first time I've played it. It wasn't pretty for the most part, but it still times out perfectly that, all right, great, this thing's over here. I've killed those things. I get to run over and I can still do this. And for me, that's a pretty cool thing in an open world game of that was an organic moment of me being able to do all that, take those guys out. I didn't fuck it up. I didn't die. I got to move on to the next thing.
Oh, that's cool.
And then you start traversing your way up here. You'll notice a jump cup eventually because literally I get to the last one and then fall down because I'm stupid and didn't jump right. But you know.
You're looking good so far.
So though. I know. And that's what I'm thinking too. I'm like, in my head, I'm like, what a great thing that was. I'm like, and then I just screwed up the jump. Jump up here though. Again, this is a good one. Again, this is on regular PlayStation 4 in terms of draw distance.
And that blows my mind because this looks very, very good. And the colors are beautiful. Like, I can only imagine what this looks like with HDR and 4K and all that stuff.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, and that's from the very beginning, the game's beautiful. I think, like, and this is what we saw, I think, in that conversation. Sometimes the characters interacting look a bit strange. I noticed teeth always look strange, but like you're about to see, I think the most impressive things. I'm just like, I'm looking around, great, and then it's just rappel down, boom, this whole thing, that, and it's like, dude, that's fucking awesome. You know what I mean? Like, what a great ride of that whole thing was. That entire section right there, amazing. And I get a great trophy. Yeah, I'm pretty stoked about that. But here you go. At first I thought the map was freaking out, but as I pan out, I figure out what's happening is, it's doing that so it can show you Fog of War lifting, populating there. You see a bandit camp is that blue thing up there. The little fires, I'm sure there's gonna be a trophy for collecting them all. Mm-hmm. Those are where you can save. This is moving into a bandit camp. Now, interesting here, just a shout out so you know a little bit about the HUD, right? Of course, what you're seeing on your screen, top right, XP, you see me leveling up down there, weapons down below that, items over there. Up here in the top left, obviously the red is my health, below it, the green is how much medicine I have in my bag. Mm. So as I start, like, you'll see sometimes when I'm in a fight and if I get hurt, red will fill in and green will start draining out. Of course, you see the map up there, very Skyrim-like in terms of, not the map, the HUD up there. And then the eye lets you know that I'm detective and how much noise I'm making.
Cool.
So when you see me jump into stealth situations, hiding behind stuff, you'll understand better, like, what that looks like. Here, I'm like, robot mount, you stay in the water. This is me, again, using the little triangle thing. She just kept calling it a device. You see, of course, the open activities pop up here. Now I have a bandit camp. It's level 7. There were plenty of quests I got and saw that were too high level for me. I wasn't ready to go out on them and stuff like that. I think I explore the menus later on. You'll see. This is us investigating. To take over the bandit camp, at least this one, I'm not sure if it's all of them, take out all the bandits, free the prisoners. Eventually in there is like an alarm for me to take out.
Mm-hmm.
Again, very Ubisoft, very open world game. I love that kind of stuff, as you know. Again, though, and I'm playing on normal, I think this shows a little bit of like, with the robots, they're like looking over like, what's happening? The people are dumb as hell.
Really?
And it's like whatever, I don't care. I'm used to that again from Skyrim. I'm used to that again from every Ubisoft game I play. But this person comes over, I'm like, all right, cool. I'm still figuring it all out because this is my first time doing this. I wanted to do some boxes, I'm gonna do it again. But you get to run over here. I have the stealth hit, silent strike, boom.
Oh my God.
It's super rewarding, right? But then again, like, I start looting her and you hear somebody say, hey, somebody's down over there or whatever. And I'm like, oh, okay, somebody's down over there. And I use the eye again to figure out where they are, detective vision a bit. I think they clearly gotta be through this door, they're through that door. So I gotta come back around, I get caught on a rock because I'm just not, you know, used to it yet. Go through here, take them out the same way. And so then this is just what it was. And I thought, I'm like, okay, cool. Maybe if I get to the alarm and take it out, I take it over faster or something like that. You gotta kill everybody in the bandit camp. Which I was like, okay, cool, whatever. This is a different kind of kill since I'm actually coming up from behind. Get them in the side.
God damn.
But it's, I mean, how rewarding is it that you see the XP jump, you're getting items there, you're doing those different stuff.
There's a lot of systems. I think Colin's gonna like that a lot.
Oh, no, totally. Here's one of an awkward moment though, again, in terms of like, it's not perfect. It's not like, this guy's just sitting there, watch this guy. Thunk, and then up, down, okay, well. Shot in the head, looks at you, and then falls down or whatever. And this lady saw all that and is like, hey, what's going on over there? I'm gonna go investigate. That's why, sorry, Charlize Theron, there
she
you go.
She did look like a bandit, though.
She did, no, and that's the whole thing. It feels like it. So then I go through, I let people out, I do the whole thing, I take it down.
Man.
Different environment.
Every time it cuts to like these open scenes, right. I'm just like, good
and
Lord.
That's the thing, I understand again, like Sony doesn't want to bore you in Let's Plays. They want you to, it's fun, it's super fun for you to go through and explore these environments. Watching someone do it, not maybe the most exciting thing.
Well, so
but
I got
like,
a question.
Going there. From environment to environment is awesome. Yes.
So with obviously this game, it looks fantastic, yeah. Both from a visual and just like gameplay perspective.
But this is how you save, by the way, sorry. There's a quick save and then there's manual.
Camps.
Go ahead.
But so this looks like a big RPG, and you were saying that you're surprised by how RPG it is.
Right. The same thing here. I'm here for some other thing. I walk in, exclamation points start popping up. So of course I take all those side missions.
Do you think that there's a game here that you don't that isn't that open and whatever? Like, do you think that there is the more Uncharted?
I don't think, and that's what I'm talking about in terms of them bringing together all the things I love. I never finished The Witcher. I never even beat Act One of The Witcher, but I played 30 hours of The Witcher and thought it was great. You know what I mean? This seems like scaling back The Witcher, giving you a smaller map, plenty of stuff to do, but not overwhelming you to, and then mixing in all these different things. There is a game here. I don't want to spoil it for people. Again, the intro I think is really great at establishing who you are, what your place is, and then literally, it's almost like a Disney movie in a way, where they're like getting ready for that break, and it's like, all right then, that's my mission, that's what's gonna happen. Montage, you know what I mean?
Okay.
And then it's like, all right, now we're setting off on the journey to do that.
Cool.
And now granted, here, we've jumped, things have happened, like, because what happened is I got to play the intro through the first main story quest, and then they came over like, all right, we want you to show the open world, we want you know to see get a taste of that. So we're jumping you ahead. Here's what's happened in very broad terms, and cool. I don't think it's worth telling you about it because I think everybody should try to go in as dark as they can.
Cool.
And I know it seems like we're showing you a lot. We're not showing you shit in terms of like the story and what the actual hooks cool. are. Here though is again. This is like one, because I'm not stupid. I knew it was an action RPG when it got announced. We got started seeing it, and so I expected RPG light elements like this. So okay, I got a skill point. Now I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna have triple shot. I'm gonna do this, but there's so much of that mixed with so much of the conversations, mixed with so much of the side things, mixed with the crafting up there. Where yeah, I want to get a bigger pouch. Inventory management, the map, going through the way the quests are laid out. You know what I mean? In terms of here's your main quest, your side quests. Here are more of the tall guys you got to crawl up, do all these different things. Like, it's a meaty ass game.
Yeah.
And I jumped, of course, because I'm Greg Miller, into the trophies. Majority of them hidden. The ones that you could see were get to level, 10, get to level 50. Again, showing. What is video games in 2017, right? You get reward boxes similar to, any
loot
of the Overwatch, if you want to do that, Division. You pick them up when you beat certain missions or anything else. This is a different way of riding into that same place we saw, that Derelict City. I forget the name of it, right? Oh, Devil's, whatever it is, Thirst. But here, I thought this was cool, of like, I just wanted to show you this. Okay, cool. I'm on a side mission that I picked up at that town, though, to find this guy's hunting party, his friends that went away. But when I got here, I had to look around, because I'm super excited to find out what happened, right? It turns out, though, when you get here, what happened is we have two of these sawtooths. Now, sawtooths get introduced early on, and teach you how to take down one. You want to use these shock wires to take them down, because then they get shocked, you can run up and hit them. You can't hit them over and over again, though. You got to run up and get one good hit on them. So I put some of the battle in here. It's straightforward, and I don't want to say it's like a thinking man's thing, because you know what to do, but it took me a while to get my rhythm down, as you see me rolling into him, right? You see I'm detected. You see the other sawtooth has the red circle filled in. I'm actually being pursued, as you're going to see in a second here, because they give chase to you, but you have to take what your advantage is, right? It's the cat and mouse game, literally, of you being the small mouse, you being able to lose them, and then when you're inside tall grass like this and you crouch, you're invisible. You see my eyes closed up there.
Yeah.
So I get to jump out, I get to make that quick strike, and then make my move.
Do they feel like a threat?
Yes, 100%. It's one of those where, even when I felt like I had, I understand what I need to do, I understand how to do it, I still died a couple times. Mm-hmm. And it is that ever-escalating thing. We're gonna end on a giant monster that I get my ass kicked by and have no idea how to fight, right? And like, in the very beginning, when you start meeting the other creatures, that's tough. When you met the first sawtooth, that was tough. But now that I have more weapons at my disposal, now that I've been at it longer, it's easier. And then even here, learning the mechanics of this fight, right? Of like, the first time I took down the sawtooth, I ran up, stabbed it in the face, and then kept hitting it, and then tried to fall back, and it was like, no. But if I stab it in the face once and fall back, it doesn't see me. I'm using my lure technique, right? So he doesn't even know where I am right now. He's coming to investigate something. I can run up, stab him, fall back, do it all over again. And then, this is, me being, using the weapons that I was familiar with at the time. I have fire arrows, I don't use them. I think at this point I have bombs, I didn't use them. This is, again, moving into a different thing. These were new enemies that have just been introduced to me. This is a corrupted zone. Of course, they talk about this corruption, right? That you wouldn't say the people and the machines have been living in peace, but they've been living together and it hasn't been that big of a deal. Yeah, sawtooths you'd be worried about, or not the throw, but this corruption's making things different and change, and we don't know why, so we need to figure it out. I put this in here, first off, because it shows corrupted, it shows a different time kind of enemy, it shows the stealth kill. One of my things playing it was I wasn't sure how much leeway they gave me with those stealth kills, and like they give you a pretty good amount where it looks like even if that other guy's right there, he's not seeing me do a stealth kill because I'm still doing everything right, which is interesting and again, very RPG-like in terms of like, okay, cool, we're not gonna bust your balls on this certain thing. We're gonna let you get in there, mix it up a bit, fight some things.
Can you ride the Tauntaun?
You can, yes, you can, that's the whole thing. This is a different one again, right? But this, I've learned how to override their systems. So whereas I rode the guy that was basically a horse, this is basically a bull. I've learned how to get in there and take over him, so now I can get on him, jump on this.
Can you, the long necks, can you take them over?
Theoretically, I imagine, you already do, right? I don't think you can walk them around. You take them over to figure everything out.
Yeah.
The way the game explains itself, or at least at the time, is that yes, because I kept seeing this one creature and she's like, I don't know how to take that one down, but if I bet I went to where they get me, and this is, by the way, I figured out how beautiful the game is. I'm like, damn, look at this
whole shot.
Yeah, you like that? The slow ban? You know what's up. But I'm building something here. They have photo mode available from the get-go. So I jump in to fuck around with that a little bit here. There is a character, or another one of the creatures that you see, and she kept saying, like, oh, if I knew where that guy came from, I bet I could figure it out. And that's the whole thing, is that there's these, I believe, we're gonna see in a second, I think it's Citadel, but I think I'm saying it wrong. This is my photo. I like this photo a lot. I'm gonna tweet it out when the embargo lifts. You go to where they are being built, right? Oh, here we go. This is like, the guys were all, the gorilla guys came over and were watching me, like, oh, you're pretty confident, huh? I'm like, yeah, I'm feeling pretty good. I know what I'm doing now, you know. I take down those guys, like, oh, you should go take on this guy. I'm like, who's this guy? Like, oh, he's a Thunderjaw. I'm like, oh, okay, cool. And you get over there, he's like Godzilla. He's got a laser on his head, he's knocking down trees. This is, you get in there, you can actually look at anybody you scan, know a little about them, figure out, like, yeah, what their weaknesses are, what their strengths are, how to take them on and do different things with them. So I was like, okay, cool, I'm gonna get my ass kicked. And I do, of course.
Yeah.
I don't think I put the kill in here. But the fight is in here, and it's also, yeah, a little, these last two sections I put in here were kind of just extended fighting because I felt like we jumped around so much. But yeah, you go in and you're able to see what's happening. You know that you see these different creatures and you think that you're gonna be able to take them down at some point. The trailers, Colin and I have given them shit sometimes because it seems like they're giving stuff away with, like, you're going to, like, what looks like a machine world or whatever. We're gonna come up here after this, a little bit of this fight. I just wanted to show the power and how destructive it is. He, like, if you notice his tail and stuff, he's knocking down trees and stuff throughout the him being on screen here. Still a beautiful creature. But I have no idea how to fucking take him down yet. You know what I mean? I'm sure I have to be a little more powerful, have a few different things, but... lots of good stuff in terms of that. But then, yeah, like, there's these different robot citadels, and that's not what they're... I don't think it's citadel, something else with a C. It's coming up here in a second. That, theoretically, that's where the robots are making each other or whatever, or, like, that's when you think.
The robot sex house?
Yeah, robot sex house, exactly. It's a bathhouse. Robots at bathhouse. But you see, I'm coming up, I'm doing this, and you see at the top of my screen there on the little radar, I have that little blue triangle. Mm-hmm. There it is. You see it built into the wall, not a natural phenomenon, a cauldron. And so you go up on these cauldrons, and I only know what was told to me in the preview briefing of, like, you think that's where they come from. I don't know. I didn't go into it. Brandon Jones was next to me. Shout out to Easy Allies. I looked at his screen when he went in, and I was like, oh, okay. You'll see my demo ends with me not going in it because I couldn't capture that. And I wanted to make sure I got as much footage as possible to actually show what's going on in the game. So this is just an extended, I'm gonna walk around and show you.
I like how you're fucking motherfuckers up with your horse.
Right, yeah, that was the thing. It's like, now once you've overridden them, you can use them as a thing too. But then he gets hurt, I feel real sad.
Yeah.
I get bucked off, he starts sparking and freaking out.
Oh no.
Yeah, yeah, see, there we go. Trouble afoot at the Circle K here for robot horse.
Robot horse.
But see, like, that's the thing of, like, I felt like I was kicking ass there, right? But as soon as I'm off and I'm exposed, totally different ball game in terms of, like, you know, does it feel like it? I start spamming my health over there, or getting ready to spam my health, making all these moves, but trying to, as they focus on the other threat, so then I have to get to the tall grass to see if anybody actually knows where I am. You see that guy stalking me over there.
You got that hair camo.
Exactly, exactly. But then here, like, you're able to, you know, use your silent strike, get over there, and that's how, I mean, that's, for me, what this game's gonna be all about is stealth.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Getting in there, going, I'm sure you're gonna be able to put more power into your arrows, more power into your fighting, more, you have melee attacks you didn't really see from here other than the stealth stuff. But in terms of jumping in there and doing it, that's what it's all about.
Seems like she speaks appropriately. Like,
yeah.
She's not silent,
yeah,
but it's not too many quips and stuff.
Sure, 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 like, sure, sure.
It always feels natural.
No, her voice acting's great. Again, it's Ashley Birch. This is the cauldron here. I'm still, again, I'm not sure if they ever confirmed it's Ashley. As soon as we saw the first trailer, I was like, that's Ashley. That's Chloe from Life is Strange. And I remember tweeting about it and somebody giving me a coy response. It's clearly her, 1,000%. I'm not, it's probably been announced by this. Because again, it's literally like, new story trailers come out and I'm like, don't need to see it, don't want to play it. And I was worried that playing 4 hours of the game would make me feel like, oh fuck, like, no, you know what I mean? Like, it's gonna suck to jump back into that. I can't wait to go through the opening again. I can't wait to get the connective tissue that gets all this together. And let alone here, like, I didn't even do the story mission.
Yeah.
I just ran around, I just did, you know, the bullshit I wanted to do and took down stuff and tried to show you cool things.
Well, it looks awesome.
Good.
Man, Horizon Zero Dawn. It's one of those games that, like, I really felt like it could have went either way. And this to me, it sells it entirely.
Well,
like,
and
I played E3 and I thought it was great.
I'm glad you, because usually, like, here, because last night I walked in the door and Colin was like, how was it?
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, dude, it's a train wreck. And he's like, what? And I'm like, nah, I'm fucking with you, it's awesome. You know what I mean? But, like, the way I described it to him, and I'm sure we'll talk about it on PS I Love You XOXO, go post questions on the thread right now for, we can talk about this. is the fact that Colin and I like similar games, obviously. You know what I mean? Uncharted or this, you know what I mean? Like, we get our, but then there's games where he goes and plays this weird, nerdy JRPG, and I go and play Lego Dimensions or whatever. And like, this is a game that is our, there's no Venn diagram here, there's a circle.
Yeah.
It's the conversation trees, it's the upgrading, it's
10 years ago, my brother
the mixture. I feel like it's an insult to say, oh, it's Witcher Light, you know what I mean? Because there's clearly a ton of content in it, but it's not Witcher in the sense I go in there and I'm just getting batoned to death and I'm like, I can't see the end of this. Uh-huh. You know what I mean? I don't understand how I'm gonna finish this game.
Yeah.
This game I see myself platinuming as long as there isn't, play through it again now on extra hard mode or whatever, yeah. You know what I mean?
I'm really excited to see the next week of like, once this goes up for us and all the other media outlets put their stuff up, because I know that we were super high on the game, like kind of funny, but I know that outside of that, like of course people were stoked, but I do know like other media outlets were a little bit more like, we'll see, I don't know, and like they were trepidatious about it in the same way we're trepidatious about Scalebound.
Sure.
Where it's like, it looks cool, but whatever, whereas we were like super stoked on it. This, I think, is gonna get everybody stoked.
And that's the thing, is like, for real, if people are putting up Let's Plays from this event, go watch them all, because I'd love to see what weapons they were using, what tactics they were using, how they branched off and did it. I never even talked about this. When you see an enemy, the robo enemies, you can, like, they're on patrol, you can use the eye to look at them, and then and it'll tell you what their patrol is.
Cool.
So that you can then stealth, go set yourself up. Over here, I think I can just kill his best friend. So he's like, what's going on with Timmy? Now, of course, if somebody killed you in front of me, I'd be like, red alert, someone's here. But they're like, maybe he's sleeping. Maybe there's robots asleep on the job. I got to get on it.
Anyways, Horizon Zero Dawn.
Yes.
Will be available, do you remember when?
28th, February 28th.
February
it's a Tuesday.
28th.
Not long now.
My God.
Not long now.
Well, looks fantastic. Thank you for going down and playing it, Greg. Thank you. No problem. Doing this.
Thank you for watching. Sorry it was so much shoved into one thing.
Leave your questions for PS I Love You XOXO over at
kindoffunny.com/PSQ. The Q's for questions. But yeah, give me topic of the week. I'll answer questions there for you. We'll kick Colin out of the room.
Love you.